start for Australia. Up the slope for Alyssa Healy. It was a half stop in the cover region, but a despairing dive from that Siver Brunt. And Australia, they're away. Yeah, afternoon, Charlotte Edwards.
Good evening. What a night here at Lords, and what a way to start this T20 at Lords. Alyssa Healy and a misfield, unfortunately, from Sophia Dunkley, but Australia are underway.
A bit of a drag down from Charlie Dean, and easy pickings this time for Alyssa Healy, just helping the ball on its way. So an excellent start for Australia, back to back boundaries.
Charlie Dean trying to compensate and going more into Alyssa Healy's legs. Just a tickle on that, runs away again.
That's where she wants to be, Charlie Dean. No, a lot of players playing this evening haven't played at Lords before. Charlie Dean has, of course, playing the London Spirit in the 100 competition.
Oh, yes, Dino. Good, Charlie.
Yeah, great opportunity as well for Charlie Dean. The first time that she's opened the bowling for England in a T20. And she's got the big task of trying to unroot either Alyssa Healy or Beth Mooney, ideally both. Beth Mooney has such a good record against England in this format of the game. Averages are around 50. Player of the match in the first game. 61 not out. Edgbaston. Oh. Oh, no. What do you think England have to do tonight to make sure they stay in this series?
I think play like they did the other night. I thought they were outstanding at the Oval on Wednesday night. Enjoyed watching it at home.
A handy over for Australia to start proceedings. 10 runs coming from it. Australia, 10 without loss.
Yeah, I thought they were outstanding on Wednesday night. And there's Catherine Siver Brunt doing what she does well. And she's ringing that bell very hard there. And the England team clapping one of the greats.
Really great occasion for Catherine Siver Brunt to ring the bell. We see another Siver Brunt in action this evening, this time on the pitch. Nat Siver Brunt will take the second over. We saw her take the first over at Oval. Looks to get that swing early on. Really enjoys having the new ball in her hand, slip in place. Bit of protection out on the offside for Beth Mooney. She does like to go through the cover region.
Yeah, I thought England bowled really, really well at Beth Mooney on Wednesday night. They had some good field set. I like this field to her with having a deep point. She's very good through that area. And I think one of the reasons for Charlie Dean opening the bowling is because I thought she looked really threatening against her as well.
Yeah, what did you make of the change? Obviously, they took Freya Davis out and replaced her with Charlie Dean. Are there any other sort of changes that you might think about for England?
I like the option they went with three spinners. I think spinners have bowled really well against the Australians throughout the A series. And so clearly they see that as a weakness within the Australian team. I think having a good off spinner as well to bowl against Beth Mooney, who is such a key player for Australia, And I thought, you know, they bowled brilliantly at her on Wednesday night, and you know, she was only going at a runner ball, and when you're chasing 180, that's massive in the context of the game.
And you feel as well now, I think we were talking about it, the difference between Australia and England is that you look down at that Australian lineup and they are just packed with all-rounders. Lissa Healy has so many options that she can turn to with the ball. We were just talking to Grace Harris and even saying to her, do you think you're going to get a bowl?
But, that is middle.
You know, even some of the best bowlers in domestic level for Australia don't get the opportunity.
Grace had a lot to say for herself, which was unusual.
Oh, an aerial for just a moment, and it will race away. Just past Sophie Eccleston at mid-on. So Australia continuing this good start.
This is a class shot from Elissa Healy, just getting over to off stump, seeing that gap there between mid-on and mid-wicket. Perfectly played. And now Nat Siverbrunt wants Amy Jones up to the stumps.
Yeah, you could see that delivery before. Elissa Healy just using her crease. Chance! And down. Elissa Healy, just wonder if she was trying to replicate a similar sort of shot that had got her that boundary before, whether it's just stuck in the pitch or if she's just been early on it.
Yeah, I think she was just slightly early. Sharp chance to Nat Siverbrunt. She'll be disappointed. Great pair of hands.
Yes, Nat.
Well, we'll find out how big a moment that was as the game pans out. But that is as it is. Lissa Healy, she survives. Two overs gone. Australia, 16 without loss. What do you reckon, Lot? How hard are these, obviously, in the bowlers follow through?
They look easy when they're slowed down, but when that's happening in real play, that's hard. Especially as a seam bowler, because sometimes, you know, your head's down and you have to react. That was low as well. You'll be disappointed.
Well, we saw some dropped catches in the previous game at the Oval. They were the ones that were sort of skied up in the air. Tylee McGrath dropped one. This one for Nat Siverbrunt straight through. It's always hard to, I guess, reorientate yourself in your follow through. You have to then track the ball in. And Nat Siverbrunt sets herself high standards.
Wait.
And Lauren Bell. A bit more pace now for England. Still in the infancy of her international career. First time that she hasn't had the new ball for England in T20 cricket. Oh, Beth Mooney looking to advance down. Oh, it's pretty well bowled in the end from Lauren Bell. Perhaps saw her coming.
And I think the reason for Beth Mooney having to advance is because this field is set up for her. You know, she's so used to just using the pace, cutting it through that offside. But she's now trying to access probably slightly straighter to Sophie Eccleston's right hand. Yeah, and I think that's where England have been brilliant in terms of their field positionings to Beth Mooney, because she was so prolific in the first game. And a quality player. It's now Elissa Healy. She's the one they need to keep quiet.
Well, Elissa Healy going again. She doesn't get all of it, and there's been a lot of rain throughout the day here in St John's Wood, and it's just plugged. Now Sophie Eccleston to retrieve it.
Oh, that was slightly unlucky. Just plugged in the outfield. So. Beautiful shot from Elissa Healy. But yeah, for all money, I think she thought that was four. Unfortunately not.
Beth Mooney wanted to come through. Alyssa Healy wasn't having any of it. That's one thing that I think a lot of the Australian batters are aware of with Beth Mooney. She is keen to try and get down the other end. Excellent, really good from Lauren Bell. Bit of shape, bit of nip. Good way to finish the over, a good over as well. Just four runs coming from it, 20 without loss. First time these sides have battled it out in this format of the game, a T20 between England and Australia. They've played in a few ODIs, the last ODI back in 2013. Alyssa Healy, she was carrying the drinks. That's a good shout. Alyssa Healy was pretty much walking. She knew straight away that that was probably clattering in to middle and leg. Oh, Charlie Dean, a change of ends worked well for her. And England, they have their first.
Yeah, this is a great delivery from Charlie Dean. Just goes on, and that's right in front. Alyssa Healy didn't even look at the umpire. She walked off. Dean gets the first wicket for England. Healy has to go for 16. And Australia is 20 for one.
That's a big moment for England. They know how destructive Alyssa Healy could be. Played it threatening 37 the other evening at the Oval off not a huge amount of balls. So I'll be pleased to see the back of her. Charlie Dean, someone who knows these conditions pretty well, has just got Alyssa Healy trapped on the crease. Not a lot going for that in terms of for Alyssa Healy. Talia McGrath, number one T20 batter in the world at the moment, comes out to join Beth Mooney. Really good strike rate, 141. 30 games. Feel that she's not even got near her ceiling as an international cricketer. Gone for that deep extra cover because they know that Talia McGrath is so strong in that region. This is why she's here. Healy just looking to work it perhaps a little bit too square. Good take from Amy Jones. Just a little bit of extra bounce for Charlie Dean. He's not tall, but manages to get the ball skidding through. Interesting. Beth Mooney, 4 off 11. You don't see that too much, do you? She's normally into the swing of things quite quickly. For that big shot through the cover region.
Such a big area for Talia McGrath, very offside dominant.
Good, really good from that Sibber Brunt. There was a little bit of hesitation from the Australian batters. They were just able to get through for a single. England just pulling it back nicely. 4 overs gone. Australia 23 for 1.
Another mix up here with Mooney and McGrath the other night. It happened at the Oval. And they've been so good together, these two. They've always been part of big partnerships for Australia.
A lot of power, a lot of depth and a lot of skill within that batting lineup for Australia. Ash Gardner, powerful when she wants to be. Elise Perry, how good was she the other evening? 51 of just 27 balls. Just saw her side fall short by 3 runs. Thought as well after the loss that Australia had. It's quite dangerous, isn't it? I think when you have the quality of Australia and they do come into a game of the back of it, a loss, you just feel that they're going to lift their game even more.
Yeah, certainly that, and playing at Lord's, opposition teams and international teams always raise their game here.
Well, aerial for a moment, but through up the slope here at Lord's. Welcome boundary for Australia.
Yeah, this line is probably not the line to bowl at Talia McGrath, especially if it's not swinging. She loves to free her arms. Wasn't quite timed, but enough to race away.
Few of those from Darcy Brown in the game at the Oval, one for the over, and actually not a bad delivery. They've got the field set for it. They have a deep square leg and a deep fine leg as well. No one out on the offside, even though that is McGrath's strength, but with the angle of the ball and up the slope, well, that's the way to go. And again,
been a good spell from Lauren Bell. She's mixed it up well. Another slightly short. England will look to go short at Talia McGrath. They see that as her weakness.
Oh, this is excellent from Lauren Bell. After that boundary earlier in the over, she's just pulled it back brilliantly.
Yeah, and the communication between Mooney and McGrath isn't great. There's another bit of indecision there from them both. England have come back well. The first two overs went for 16 and now 27 for one of nearly 5 overs. Very good from England.
Brilliant. Really nicely done by Lauren Bell. Excellent over. Just the 4 runs coming from it. Australia 27 for 1.
T20 component of this Women's Ashes continues here at Lords.
Yes, Dino. Good, Dino.
And Tammy Beaumont, we're now used to crowds at these games, and we're used to nail-biting fixtures, and it feels as if we're going to be in for another one this evening.
Yes, Charlie.
Yeah, I think it's building atmosphere. It's always a great place to play at Lords.
Little standing sweep from Beth Mooney that finds the boundary line.
Just sliding onto the pad of Beth Mooney. It's well put away. It's a bad ball from Charlie Bean. Despairing dive from Lauren Bell. Much needed boundary there for Beth Mooney.
And Dean does well to get a hand on it. Last over the power play. Australia looking just to try and capitalise. And there's only two fielders outside that inner circle.
Yeah, this is hit back with some force. That's going to go down, unfortunately, as a drop catch. But for me, that saved a certain boundary. Charlie Dean is one of the best spinners off her own bowling. She's incredibly frustrating to play against. You feel like you're getting that one to long on, and she's always there.
Yeah, it's Amy Jones just making sure that the long off in play at the moment is just a fraction wider. No, now she's coming back again. She's a fraction straighter. That's exactly where Beth Mooney goes to. So no changes in either of these two teams coming into the third of the T20s. And reaction time was brilliant from Dean.
Yes, Dino!
Gets into a powerful position, knows that she can go either left or right. She needed to go left and she did it well. This time it's Tali McGrath, a little shimmy down the wicket and just stands and admires her handiwork.
It's very fast and clever footwork from Tali McGrath. Just lofts it over that mid-off inside the ring. Time to perfection.
Looks to go again, squeezes it to Capsey at backward point. It's a dot ball to finish off the power play. It's Australia's lowest power play in the series so far. It's 36-1. They started with a bit of a bang, Tammy, and then England fought back.
Yeah, I think England will be the happier of the two sides. Anytime you kick someone at six and over in a power play, you're pretty happy. But yeah, a little bit wayward for that first over. Back-to-back boundaries for Alyssa Healy. And some beautiful shots there, using the crease to get across to off stump.
Yeah!
But that was the big wicket. Alyssa Healy is the aggressor in the power play. Beth Mooney tends to bat through. A little bit of width on offer, Tali McGrath accepted gratefully, and Mooney putting the bad ball away there. And that shot there for me is trademark Tali McGrath.
Have you ever walked on an LB?
I'm probably not a walker, but I think there's sometimes you just know, don't you?
Lisa Healy certainly knew she wasn't waiting to see the finger go up. So one wicket falls in the power play. Heather Knight can now use it. Two more fielders outside that inner circle. And she's thrown the ball to Danny Gibson, who had her first game for England at Edgbaston. First wicket in international cricket was Beth Mooney. Might have almost been a second one too, but it falls short of Nat Siverbrunt down the slope here at Lords. And that's what Tali McGrath will like to do. And she does it in two different ways. She'll use the crease. She'll come in and out. So she'll come down towards the bowlers. But what she'll also do is work laterally across to the offside and the onside as well.
I also think it's just an indication that potentially the pitch is just a little bit on the slow side. Both Beth Mooney and Tali McGrath look to use their feet at the moment.
That's clubbed. It's not got all of it. And it's gone to Alice Capsey, who cannot believe it. It hit high on the blade of Tali McGrath's bat. She knew straight away she was in strife. A wicket in the power play and a wicket just outside the power play here for England.
Danny Gibson hits that hard length into the leg stump of Tali McGrath. She tries to get underneath it. Doesn't get hold of it, and it's a simple catch for Alice Capsey. Tali McGrath got to go. 10 from 13 deliveries, Australia. 37 for 2.
Everything going England's way at the moment. A little sloppy in that first over. Heather Knight having won the toss, sending Australia in a crunch match. A reminder, the Ashes is on the line. A win to Australia this evening. We'll see them retain the Ashes. A win for England keeps them in the hunt. Ashley Gardner comes out to the middle, her first ever game at Lord's. Wonderful all-round record. Been quite the day. We've got it looks as if another magnificent crowd coming in to Lord's. We've got the Ashes on the line, so we need to have you here, Claire, to talk all things Ashes, the rivalry, and a very special moment that happened behind the pavilion about an hour ago.
Yeah, it was a lovely ceremony, wasn't it? We were both there in 1998. Yeah, when the women's Ashes were first created in terms of the actual burning. Lottie was there as well. As adversaries, Mel. So it's amazing to see, you know, to think back 25 years and think of where the women's game was then and what we're doing now. Really important, I think, to remember where we've come from on days like this, which, you know, looking to inspire the next generation. Really special to look back. Lovely occasion.
I mean, you think that first game was back in 1976. We had some of those players out the back as well, all the way through to the game in which we played in 1998. 39 for 2 after 7. It's that moment to sort of stop and pay almost homage to all those women that we never really saw or heard about when we were playing.
Yeah, that's right. You know, there's, I think, you know, we said there's too many to kind of pay tribute to in terms of who's been part of this amazing journey. But, you know, lots of people have played their part and the game's progressed, you know, from those. That was 1998, was a 3-test match series, wasn't it? I think you might have dominated. But now to be where we are, you know, in a kind of, if you like, a reinvented Ashes with the multi-format series and some of the crowds that we're seeing now. And it's fantastic, I think, for those players from the past to be invited today and people who've played their part in that journey to where the game is now. It's really special.
Sarah Glenn into the attack. And Mooney goes after a straightaway. Will it go all the way? No, just bounces. It's a little counterpunch here from Australia. Crowd not as excited about the shot from Mooney, but speaking of the crowd, when I walk around Lord's at a women's game, it was 2017 today. When I look at the makeup of the crowd, I think that's one of the things I think I'm most proud of and something that the MCC Foundation has played a really big role in.
Yeah, that's right. I think we've seen that through the 100 as well, you know, that had that those kind of two key objectives of kind of making the game more gender balanced, but also opening up, you know, diversifying the fan base to cricket. And days like this and the 2017.
Goes again. Another couple of skips across the grass. And Mooney picks up her second boundary.
Yeah, that 2017 World Cup final, was such a young, family-oriented, gender-balanced crowd, I suppose. The work of the MCC Foundation is so close to my heart. You know, I'm a trustee of the MCC Foundation, and it's the charity partner that we're putting today's match on with. It's doing amazing things for girls, both in this country and overseas, to give girls the chance to play, particularly in the talent system here, and it's over 70 hubs around the country with over 30% of the participants are girls.
Down.
Yeah, space again. This time she goes straight down the ground, Beth Mooney, and she's enjoying Sarah Glenn coming into the attack as the 50 comes up for Australia. You mentioned girls here in England, but also overseas. I think that phrase global citizen is really important, particularly for the countries like Australia and India and England, who have a foothold and have some money.
Yeah, that's right. You know, those of us with that kind of privilege and finances can do so much good for the game. And, you know, the MCC and Lords, to have its own foundation with kind of global support, it's, you know, regarded as a very powerful brand and institution and the home of cricket and so on. So it's really important that it does that good work. And I was privileged enough, I went last year with the MCC Foundation to coach cricket to Syrian refugees in Lebanon. 50% of them were girls who'd kind of fled war-torn Syria. And for them to have the chance to play this game, you know, in an environment where they've got so little, it was incredible to see. And so if, you know, for people listening, if you haven't heard about the MCC Foundation, take a look. It really is transforming lives through cricket, and I'm delighted to be involved with them.
Oh, yes, Glennie!
Claire, thank you for everything you do for the game as well. It's been absolutely brilliant. That's the end of the eighth over. It's 55 for two. If I asked you goosebump moment over the last few years, what stands out?
Goosebump moment, if it's with England women, which is obviously my passion and where I've come from, then it would be sitting up there in that stand watching Anya Shrubsole take that last wicket in the 2017 World Cup final. It was the most incredible day for anyone that saw it or had the joy of being here. It was a transformative day, really, and it's enabled so much of what we've been able to go on and do. But yeah, I mean, there have been many, and it's an amazing platform to keep building from.
Can I just add to that? I think the moment for me that makes me catch the feels as an England player was when before play we celebrated Rachel Hayhoe-Flint. We had Eileen Ash ring the bell, and we had the 1973 and 1993 World Cup winners.
Yeah, and again, you know, that was... Yeah, Eileen Ash, aged over 100 at the time, ringing the bell. You know, she played for England women before the Second World War and after the Second World War. Rachel had obviously only passed away a few months before. And like you say, Tammy, to see World Cup winners from the past, and again, it speaks to that, you know, the event this afternoon, Mel, in terms of recognising the past and why we're all here. And, you know, we've all got the chance to take it forward, so...
Well, as I said before, Claire, cannot thank you enough for all the work you've done behind the scenes, plus on the field all those many years ago when we were arch rivals. Nice to know.
You're nicer now, Mel. I'm much nicer.
I don't think I am, really. But keep up the great work.
Thanks so much.
And here's to a wonderful day this evening. Thanks,
thank
Claire.
You.
Wonderful to chat all things in the past, because, Tammy, you've been on TV multiple times playing the game. There's so many of these wonderful women. Enid Bakewell at 82 is still playing cricket, which is absolutely phenomenal.
She's still coaching us at the Blaze, actually, if we don't perform.
Good save, good save.
And it's, days like this that we can say thank you, which is absolutely brilliant. Meanwhile, a partnership is forming. 20 from 12 between Beth Mooney and Ash Gardner.
Yeah, it's typical Beth Mooney, isn't it? Seizing the opportunity to sees some initiative for Australia.
Mooney goes up and over the offside and long and well. She's a London Spirit player in the 100 and last season's format. She knows the ground. She's played well in that format. She's playing well in this T20 format as well.
Yeah, just playing with the field there. Mid-off up in the ring, seizing the opportunity to go up and over.
What she's really trying to do here is try and knock the best bowler in the world off her length a little bit, so you can really see that use of the crease coming out. The ball before for the four over the top, pushing back for the single to the onside. Australia will want to try and put some early pressure on Eccleston. Seven runs coming from her first over at 62 for two. When the coin goes up and it lands in Heather Knight's favour, which was probably a surprise for her to begin with because she's lost the other one so far, and she decides to have a bowl, there was probably a few raised eyebrows around.
Yeah, Heather winning the toss doesn't happen that often in this series, it would seem. But I actually wasn't surprised to bowl first. Having played here at Lord's quite a few games in the 100, sometimes the pitch can be a little bit different to how it looks. So, yeah, I wasn't surprised when they looked to bowl first. You know what you got to chase, you know how hard you have to go, you know how to marshal the innings. And, yeah, I think we've seen that potentially it isn't the easiest wicket, but if you get in on it like Beth Mooney has, there's value for runs as well.
Nat Siverbrunt, six runs off her first over. She opened up with Dean this evening. I think all the Aussies that are sitting up late at night at home probably thought she did that in the World Cup final and Australia went on and put 356 on the board.
Don't remind me, Mel. No, we knew it was a good wicket and we knew we were going to be chasing quite a lot, but we also felt the way to try and overcome a very good Australian team was to try and go out and be aggressive in a chase, and it didn't work because of one very good innings from Melissa Healy.
Short ball to Gardner. She goes after it. She knows she's going to cop a couple of those in her innings. Let's not forget a magnificent 100 from Nat Siverbrunt in that final as well, which is one of the best innings I've certainly ever seen. Left-handed Mooney on strike. Gets away with one there, Nat Siverbrunt, more so on the line than the length. It's got the protection in the field though. Gardner with runs at Edgbaston. She likes that ground, played exceptionally well throughout the Commonwealth Games there, helping get Australia the first ever gold medal in the women's cricket competition. Missed out at the Oval. Gets on the pads. She'll feel as if she's missed out there as well.
Yeah, Ash Gardner's crucial to this T20 Australian team. I feel like she's improved so much all-round game in the last couple of years. No ground is big enough for her if she chooses to take the rope on.
Oh, bold Nat.
That's probably where you look at partnerships like this, and Australia usually tinker with their lineup a little bit to try and make sure that the two players out there do have a point of difference. I know when Meg Lanning was playing in the team that if it was Beth Mooney that departed, she would come in, Gardner would come in, if it was Healy. Trying to be a little bit funky there, Beth Mooney. Nat Siverbrunt, stump to stump, you miss, I hit. And there goes Australia's third.
Just as you think Beth Mooney's set, It's the off cutter from Nat Siverbrunt. Couldn't get enough bat on it to get it past the stumps. And she's got to go. The big wicket there for England. A useful innings of 32 from 27 balls, 60-63 after 10.
Danny Gibson. It's Perry. She's been doing so many warm-ups before she went out there. She's actually just dropped the bat before she's faced the ball.
She was actually out in front of our pod here doing some sort of advancing down the wicket things and catching a ball without her bat. At all.
She thinks she's doing the same again.
Maybe she was just thinking about the same thing.
Oopsie. Gone up a long way. Nat Siverbrunt, no chance in the end. Me to the bat.
That is good power. A little bit of advancement down the pitch. Meeting that ball about a yard and a half outside the crease, and a good strike from Ash Gardner.
Yeah, lovely strike. Siverbrunt, that wide, long on, deep mid wicket. Just interested for a while. Indication there of the pace of the pitch. Not on the quick side by any means, so they'll just be bearing that in mind when they're thinking about what a decent score is here with the outfield as well. I reckon 140, something like that.
I think anything more than 150 will be a pretty good score.
Heave leg side. And decent effort, but still goes for another boundary. Now Siverbrunt is being pushed there at deep mid-wicket. Now then, this is a decent over with two balls to go.
Just targeting that leg side. She knows the ball is angling back into her, Ash Gardner here. Clearing that front leg a little bit, targeting that downhill leg of the ground.
Slow ball, we're going to see plenty more of that. Little surprised at some of the tactical decisions made by England. Charlie Dean, her first over from pavilion end. I would have thought you'd want the spin of the off spin to fight the slope a little bit. In the end, she did bowl from the nursery end. Elise Perry, fantastic half century. A couple of sixes right at the end at the oval. And the game was England's. Her fastest T20 international 50 for Australia. I wondered if Sarah Glenn, too, might have bowled her over from the wrong end. But either way, they're three down, 77 for three.
Deep batting lineup, isn't it, all the way to Jess Jonathan, you would say. More than capable. Harris, Sutherland, Wareham. Jonathan to come. But, six bowlers used so far for England. Lauren Bell's been really tidy.
Expensive first over for Sarah Glenn. Beth Mooney kind of took to her a little bit. Beth Mooney, that dismissal might prove to be pivotal for England. Lovely shot down the ground. The outfield is so slow, but it we'll have to check. I think it's gone. Sophie Eccleston just picks it up. Another boundary for Ash Gardner.
Alice Capsey, she got a hand to it, but it slipped through her hand, I think, and onto the advertising triangle. She got there, disappointed with herself. Gets there, just sneaks through the hand, and that is four.
Thank you.
really looking to play that aggressive role. Lee's Perry new to the crease, so Gardner's taking control here and trying to find the boundaries, be aggressive, keep England under pressure.
Yes!
Good work. Saved a couple of runs. Don't think it would have gone for four anyway. Outfield is slow.
There's a good amount of rain has fallen the last little while, last day in particular, yesterday afternoon as well.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we had some heavy rain here in the early part of the afternoon in London, but luckily it's just sort of moved away. I think we're okay now. Oh, lovely looking shot again. The target, Alice Capsey down the ground. Better over from Sarah Glenn, 84 for three. Gloomy. Sophie Eccleston. Sometimes get a clue, Dooley, don't you, where the fielding side are with the total on the board. If you look at the offside field, they're all on the edge of the circle, giving one, effectively.
Oh, yes, false save.
Maybe the order of the day from the captain is protect the boundaries. I think on a slow pitch, on a slow outfield, don't give away an easy one. Don't let them just knock it in the gap and run. You know, the odd, those singles soon add up.
Yeah, particularly on that offside, you like to think Sophie Eccleston would very rarely get too much outside of the line of off stump. She's that good. So you can afford to be tight because they've got to play a really good shot to get inside the line of the ball and hit the ball through that offside or even get it up the hill. She's going to be so tight.
Yeah, well, she's so good. You know, she's such a good bowler. She generally has so much control with her bowling that you can kind of trust the bowler as well as a fielder. Just knocking it around for now. Finds the gap, beautifully struck. Ash Gardner has found the middle of the bat again. Frustration for Sophie Eccleston. It was a little short and wide. She doesn't bowl too many of them.
No, you can count the poor balls she bowls on one hand in a series mostly, but that is a poor delivery. A short, sat up, too easy.
Siva Brand, oh, nearly, right in front of the pod. It was always touch and go whether it was going to carry. It did carry in the end, and it does go down.
Yeah, she made good ground. Good ground around to her left. Got the hands to it. Just spilt out straight away.
still looking skywards. As I said, we've got away with it now. There is a horrible dark cloud. It normally comes from the right of your screen here, but it, hopefully we're just missing that bit there. That's normally... it's gone and missed us, but anyway, we'll have to wait and see. Nat Siverbrunt then.
You want your weather updates, don't call Nick Knight.
Correct. We all know, though, don't we? All the grounds we play that, we know where the weather generally comes, or the rain comes from.
Yeah, groundsman felt that we were relatively clear for the rest of the night when I was out there earlier. I'm going to chat to him.
Yes, Nat. Brilliant, Nat.
Plan here for Siverbrunt appears to be into the surface, maybe the pace off now and then, but making the right-handers hit the ball up the hill to the slightly longer side here at Lords.
Lisa Perry is very strong down the ground. Looks to hit the ball back past the bowler.
I like the plan, though. I like this idea. Just keep it really tight in at that middle and leg stump. Australia want to swing across the line. That's okay with England at the moment. But she does not want a drive ball, although mid on. Moving back to long on now, and fine leg is coming up.
Oh, yes, now ball.
That's where she likes hitting the ball. Not really a sweeper against the spinners, so looks to hit in front of square most of the time. Good over so far, and Australia will be looking for a boundary here, just three from the first four. Great work, terrific work, Amy Jones. Excellent delivery in the end from Nat Siverbrunt, but what worked behind the stumps from Amy Jones?
That is class, Amy Jones. She's such a good keeper. Wonderful hands. We've seen it time and time again, and this is out of the top drawer. Good short ball. Cross seam too high. Takes it, whips the bails off. And Ash Gardner, absolutely no man's land. Brilliant. Gardner goes, stumped for 32 from 25. It is 97 for four.
I don't know if she saw it coming, but she was out of her crease. Whether she just reacted or whether it was a plan anyway, but either way, fantastic reactions from Amy Jones. Oh, we're hearing it's caught. Either way, it's out. Brilliant catch or a brilliant stumping, either way. Officially, we're hearing caught. Not sure whether Amy Jones was thinking caught. Even better than we thought. A, to take the catch and to take the stumping. Yeah, much better than that. 14 gone, 98 for four.
Yeah, makes it even better with the edge, to be honest. Just in case the technology let her down, I thought whip the bails off as well. Good thinking.
So Six to go, plenty of batting still to come. Cameos, really, from Beth Mooney and Ash Gardner. That sort of surface, that sort of outfield. Lauren Bell, two economical overs so far.
Good belly.
Welcome to our viewers on the Cricket Channel and Main Event Channel. England finishing 27 without loss. That game up at Headingley is fantastically poised going into day four. And as far as this game is concerned, well, it's a relatively slowish kind of surface. The outfield is very slow. We've had a lot of rain here, as you had up in Headingley, but 100 has just come up. I don't think you need a huge, huge score here. England won the toss. They wanted to have a bowl first. And you will have just missed that. It actually was a catch. It was a brilliant stumping as well. But there was a little feather on it on the way through. So England have picked up four.
Oh, belly.
Done well there. 27 without loss, Dougie. That could have been a whole lot worse.
Yes, belly.
Oh, really good performance from the bowling group, I think, to get England back into that test match. So that will wrap up one way or the other tomorrow, one would imagine. And England looking to keep themselves in the Women's Ashes series here tonight at Lord's. So much great cricket being played around the country. And this fantastic summer, great blast action the last couple of nights. Final four have been sorted out there for next Saturday. This series is a beauty as well.
More good work from Amy Jones. Don't go out of your crease with Amy Jones behind.
Good belly.
Doing what the men were doing here in the test match. Ball just mixing it up a little bit.
Good little spell this from Siva Brunt and now from Lauren Bell. Last couple of overs have just picked things back nicely. Picked up the wicket of Ash Gardner, who was starting to find her range.
Come on, belly.
Just a little bit of light drizzle. Catching the back end of that cloud, I think. Let's hope it's not going to get any heavier. Helped on its way, cleverly played, using whatever pace there was, and there wasn't a huge amount. Grace Harris hasn't got going in the competition so far. 106 for 4-5 to go.
Well, nicely picked up for Elise Perry. Seems like that rain delay has helped her. She picks up her first boundary.
Well, the intent from Australia here is made clear. Dug in again from Gibson. And it's very well picked up, up and underneath it to get the elevation to go all the way for six.
Gibson will look to come in and hit the pitch hard. That's what she does. She's strong. Generally not a huge amount of movement through the air. That's skiddy as well.
Yeah, vastly experienced at this ground. Danny Gibson playing for the London Spirit. She'll know exactly her plans on this wicket.
Nice, Gibbo.
And I've been hugely impressed with her this year. She's improved a lot in the regional game, picked up a lot of wickets at the top of the order for Western Storm. I think she thoroughly deserves this England corner-up, and it's great to see her on the international stage.
Pace off delivery. That occasion. Yeah, I was actually chatting to Jack Brooks yesterday. He was down at Taunton, obviously playing for Somerset in the quarter-final, and he's been doing a bit of work with Danny Gibson along with Trevor Griffins, who's down there as well, head coach.
Oh, ball, give out.
We've been talking about Amy Jones and just how good she's been. There is another keeper on the scene as well, Ellie Threlkeld. Brilliant piece of work for the Thunder. Really similar delivery as well, that short ball, keeping your weight forward, taking the stumps as well at the same time. Sure, as a keeper as well yourself, Tam, pretty impressive.
Yeah, she's one of the best in the country up there with Amy Jones. Scored a few runs for the Thunder as well yesterday.
Well, a good comeback from the over after that first boundary. 10 runs coming from it. Australia, 116 for four. Just have a look at how Australia's innings has panned out so far. The lowest power play in the series for them. They didn't get off to the start that they wanted. Seventh over losses when they lost that wicket as well. And then just seemed to me after drinks, they had a chat and they... My guess is the conversation will be, let's just go, you know, let's try and take the game on now. Obviously, they've got lots of games where they can have a go at winning the series. So, in a way, let's try and build some momentum.
Fired in there from Eccleston, but just going down the leg side.
Yes, save. Yes. Yes, save.
No. It's been interesting to see how England have used Eccleston. Obviously, the first two games they've been defending, but often talk about the penultimate over being the most important one. Bowl your best bowler. They actually went against that. They saved Sophie Eccleston for the last over.
Oh, right.
Just wondered what you thought of that, Tam, from a captaincy point of view.
I think it's good captaincy from Heather Knight, actually backing somebody that's not Sophie Eccleston to take that penultimate over. Obviously, Catherine Siver-Brunt's retired now. She used to do either one of the death overs with Sophie Eccleston at the other end. But actually now you can see the mantle's being passed to Lauren Bell to take that on. And OK, yeah, maybe Edgbaston got a wicket but then went for a couple of boundaries. But it's good to see her being backed.
So you do think it's a case of, actually, we're backing someone like Lauren Bell to bowl that over, rather than saying, actually, you know, we think it's changed now. We think the last over is the most important run, rather than trying to kill it in the penultimate one.
Yeah, I think a little bit is you just know what's happening with Sophie Eccleston. You have got an absolute banker in that last over. You know she's going to deliver and somebody's going to have to produce something exceptional to knock her for even 12. So, yeah, I think it's one of those that leave it a little bit longer.
An excellent over from Sophie Eccleston. Just the four runs coming from it. 17 overs gone, 120 for four. Plenty of batting to come in for Australia. Josh Johnson, Annabelle Sutherland. Current rate they'll be aiming at around 141. I think they're in a good position to try and get past that, considering that Harris and Perry are at the crease. 8 and over, 144. So, 10 runs and over in these last three will get Australia up to 150. And that's not what England need. And that's Siver-Brunt. Well, in her final over, she's been brilliant up until then, 2 for 14. That one, just a little bit of ill discipline.
See Elise Perry here just backing away a little bit to the leg side, and Natsiva Brunt just with the overcorrection follows her a little bit too much, strays down the leg side and just helped on the way there by Perry.
Well, Perry again using her crease, looking to go leg side and manages to get the connection. Back-to-back boundaries to start this over.
Just onto that one knee to get up and underneath it, get enough elevation to get it past that short 45 fielder. It's beautifully executed from Elise Perry.
Yes, Nat, yes, Nat.
Natsiva's down, just hope that she's okay. Australia will come back for a couple. Danny White not able to restrict them. Just remembering she has got a bit of a dodgy knee at the moment, but she looks okay.
Yeah, that's not the same knee that's painful, but that looked a nasty fall there, a little roll of the ankle, but she's up and about and she looks okay.
I just wonder if it's that bit of rain that we had, it's just made the ground a bit more slippy. Back of the hand, slower ball this time. Amy Jones unable to collect it, always a tough one, standing up to the stump. So this really is not the start that England wanted after the rain break, but perfect for Australia.
This, for me, is where Elise Perry's improved her T20 game no end. She used to be very much in the traditional V, as you see the back of the hand slower ball there. Yes, it's misdirected down leg side, but helped on its way just with the glove behind square. But a couple of years ago, Elise Perry would not play a sweep shot to a spinner.
And again, shouts of catch. Here's Danny White running in, just falls short. And again, Australia able to come back for two.
Just didn't quite carry to Danny Wyatt there. The miss hit from Perry in the end does well to get a body behind it.
Oh. A bit of luck this time for Elise Perry. Just a single to finish the over, but a very good one for Australia. 17 coming from it. Two overs to go now. Australia 137 for four. Siva Brunt 2 for 31. She's bowled brilliantly considering that that last over's gone for 17. Good to see her back. Fully fit, so just the two overs to go now. This first innings, remember, it is a must-win game for England.
And it's not too much of a surprise, Lib, that Lauren Bell's in to bowl the penultimate over.
Absolutely, she's been brilliant. And for 16 off three. Oh. And that looks very, very close. Given, yeah, I don't think that would have been missing too much unless there was an inside edge. Just looked as if it was full enough. Harris and Perry are going to have a discussion. They do get two reviews each, and Perry is going to review it.
TV umpire to director, we have a player review for LBW. Original decision is out. I've checked front foot, it's a fair delivery. Can I have front on, please? Right off. Okay, DRS is down, so we will stay with the original decision. Russell, stay with your decision of out, signal now.
I just got news that the DRS system is down, so it means that the decision on the field will remain. So that's the end of Elise Perry. She's played nicely. Lauren Bell making an impact again. She's bowled brilliantly. Let's just have a look. What do you reckon, Tam?
Yeah, that's out.
Tammy DRS says out. Who needs the technical facilities when you've got Tammy Beaumont? Bit of relief on Heather Knight's face. That's the end of Elise Perry. She goes for 34. Australia 137 for 5. Oh, really good time for England to pick that wicket up. Saw how destructive Elise Perry was the other evening, back-to-back sixes, as Australia just fell 3 runs short.
Warm-up run.
I think it was that ball that went down.
Good length from Lauren Bell. Just looks as if she's going full and straight, keeping it simple. Might be a little bit of a change for Grace Harris. They just bring cover up into the ring. Leg side field out. Deep fine, deep square, deep mid wicket, long on. Has just started to come down again. You can see that on your screens. So the umpires will be keen to stay out and finish the innings. Just having another look at the dismissal of Elise Perry. Very good shout. Probably the right decision as well, even though we didn't have DRS. Continuing to change her field. Harris, no leg side dominant. Everyone out on the leg side. Offside field's up. Of course, that Hiddins hitting against the slope as well. Well, an excellent strike from Grace Harris. A welcome boundary as well for Australia.
See the plan from England, bang it in to Grace Harris. She's up to the task, she gets a lot of bat on that. It's a beautiful shot into the gap, one bounce four. Watching it all the way.
Good belly.
That's exactly what Grace Harris told us she was going to do. She came over to the pod earlier and said, I need to play straighter, don't I? A nice way to finish the over. Australia in a strong position, 145 for 5.
I do like the plan there from Lauren Bell, though. You know Grace Harris is so strong at that step hit length. To actually bang it in, make her play some cross-back shots, then follow it up with the full one, see if she knocks across it.
Yep, she's bowled nicely, 1 for 24. That's exactly what England want from someone like Lauren Bell, without Catherine Siverbrunt, Narayna Shrubsall as well. No, it will be Sophie Eccleston to bowl the last over. We've seen her do it so many times already in the series. Just making sure that they've got their field right.
Mm.
should have been taken and wasn't, dropped straight through the hands of Lauren Bell. And Charlie Dean does the tidying up. And that's really good running as well from Australia. Just going to check the boundary as well. Charlie Dean was doing the work. That's absolutely fine. Just wonder how much of a sight that Lauren Bell had, Tam. It went into the lights.
Yeah, it's always spinning in that position, but that reaction shows that she lost it there in the lights. Not too used to playing under lights these days. But probably expect that to be taken at this level.
Good strike, but not good enough, and not look good enough in the field either. Danny Gibson, this time the guilty party, should have been taken.
Just bobbled out there, didn't it?
This time she's got it exactly where she wanted it, straight down the ground. And Australia, they're making England pay now.
Yeah, that's not what you want as a bowler. Two drop catches and then reply with a boundary. It's a beautiful shot from Grace Harris, managed to get the elevation but find the gap. Never a fielder behind the bowler unless it's Basball.
150 up as well, so Australia well above par here at Lords. The average first inning score for domestic cricket here, so things like the 100, obviously Charlotte Edwards trophy as well, it's around 114. So a very decent total for Australia this evening. Straight through. There'll be frustration for Eccleston that she didn't get a wicket sooner. Still got a smile on her face, but I'm sure beneath that she would have been keen to have had the chances taken.
Fired in again from Eccleston, full and straight, crashing into leg stump. See from the muted celebration, she's saying, I'll do it myself.
And that's the end of Annabelle Sutherland. She goes to three, Australia 154 for six. Penny for your thoughts, Sophie Eccleston. Hey, Georgia Wareham. Very handy striker of a cricket ball, underrated cricketer as well, in my opinion. Brilliant in all facets of the game. And they will push for two. Harris will have to turn and go. She's going to get in. Good work, though, an excellent throw. Good hands at the stump. So that means that Australia, round 155. We're just going to check and make sure that this was out. The throw was good from Alice Capsey, who's been occupying long off regions.
Yeah, I'm ready to make my decision for the big screen.
Even though there was a despairing dive, not able to see Grace Harris over the line. Confirmation that's out. Australia will be pretty pleased with the total that they've got there, 155 for seven.
And about to get some action again. Straight away some swing and Sophia Dunkley underway.
Also think maybe a little bit of rain around. Maybe I thought the surface was quite slow. Sometimes this might just quicken the wicket up, and it will definitely suit the England batters. Danny Wyatt, what form she's in. Played beautifully at the Oval on Wednesday night.
Start from Megan Shute. Got to say this power play is crucial. Four overs of power play, you probably want 30.
Yeah, I was just thinking you've got to be up with the rate, haven't you? So you've got to be about 32 off the power play, because otherwise that rate's just going to keep climbing, get to tens. And with the outfield being a little bit slower, you've got to work hard for your runs.
Pinch one here, but it's tight, very tight indeed. Get away with it. Beth Mooney with the right hand throw misses the stumps.
They're so good at these singles in on that offside. They're quick, but that's a great throw and just in for Sophia Dunkley.
Really good lines. Both boundary riders are leg side up the hill. One at backward square, one at a mid-wicket area. So lovely from Megan Shute there.
Yeah, you feel the position for Dunkley to exploit here is over that sort of mid-on area. And that's where, with the two people out on the leg side there, the option is down the ground for Dunkley and Wyatt.
She tried, but that bottom hand, that knee collapses. We've talked about that quite a bit through the series, even in the test match. That back knee collapses a lot, doesn't it?
And that's why it's such a difficult shot, because you know, her weight's going backwards, and they know that, the Australian players. So that is actually a very, very difficult shot for Sophia Dunkley. And as her bottom hand comes through, they're really challenging her with that shot over the top.
It'll be wide, but a great take. It skidded off the surface. That is brilliant from Elisa Healy.
And to be fair, the other night there was a few five wides that went through off Megan Shute, and that's a brilliant take from Elisa Healy. Like you said, that did just skid off the surface, which is good for England. You want the ball coming on to the bat.
Whip put away. Gets a little bit of width and helps herself. Just Danny Wyatt, that is a favourite area. Could finish to the over eight without loss.
Yeah, and this is where you can't bowl to Danny Wyatt. She loves width. She finds the boundary there through backward of point. Excellent shot.
Just a classic overcorrection from a bowler. Been there. Been there, done that many a time. You let the wide one go down leg and then you overcorrect, go too far outside off, look for too much swing, it's not there. Darcy Brown. It's a good genuine pace as Darcy Brown. She'll enjoy the conditions here as well. Her two boundary riders are a deep third and a deep fine leg, so orthodox. It's tight again, but good single.
The running between Dunkley and White has been so good throughout the series. If they don't get the boundary option, they generally get off strike, and there's two very different batters as well. But as you say, Dooley, Darcy Brown on this type of wicket with a bit of assistance. I thought she's bowled well throughout this T20 series so far. 75 miles an hour first ball. Here we go.
Oh, it's got away from her a little bit. Disciplined with the ball, have England in the series so far. Better than Australia. You don't often say that. Australia are generally so good. Two wides in the England innings. Already been two here. It's not easy to get technical and do some coaching in T20 cricket. There's not a lot of time. But where do you think that comes from with Sophia Dunkley? I just think, does it start with the hands and they collapse the back knee, or does the back knee collapse first and then everything comes across?
I think the back knee collapses first, and then because she's looking to go over the top and she thinks that's how she's going to get her elevation. So I think she knows where she wants to hit the ball and she wants to go over the top. But sometimes I don't think the... I think she led with the head and then trusted her hands, I think. But that's really difficult to correct, isn't it? You know, and we've talked about this probably for the last 18 months. And you need time to correct that as well. And international players don't get time to actually go back and look at stuff like that because they're constantly playing, and she has been for the last however long.
Swings this away leg side. Couple of bounces into the boundary.
The Australians have looked to go short at Sophia Dunkley. And this is a great shot from her. Good bat on that. Good position there to... And there's a vacant square leg area, so good stuff from Sophia Dunkley.
Nice slip going to a square leg now, so no slip in place, square leg, still got third and fine leg as the boundary riders. More angle, another good take from Elisa Healy. The odd one just zipping off the surface.
Yeah, it's definitely quickened up in the first innings. And this is another fantastic take from Lisa Healy. Saved another wide.
It's nicely turned away. A decent start from England's point of view. Beauty with these small chases is you can still lose 9 wickets and win the game, so the wickets column is not an issue for the most part. Just got to keep up with that run rate or put yourselves in a position to score in the last 2-3 overs. You can see the bottom of the boots, they're very, very wet. And what happens with the bowling, you drag the outfield moisture in on the bottom of your shoes, and when you get to the drier surface, which has been under covers, just tend to skid a little bit on the spikes. No run there. That's excellent work behind point. Two overs have been bowled, 17 without loss. Absolutely brilliant again. It has just got better and better from Edgbaston to the Oval and now at Lord's. Tick over 21,600 in tonight. And they've waited patiently through a rain delay. ...17 without loss. Ash Gardner. Oh, a little outside edge straight away.
It's going to be tough for the spinners because it's really damp, the outfield, and you can see Ash Gardner rubbing that ball every single delivery. So it's going to be tough for her tonight.
Get in, get in!
Good line. Just followed Sophia Dunkley there a little bit. I think this is the better matchup from an England point of view. Danny Wyatt will look to go probably long off.
Yeah, she's certainly got... Long off is her area, but they keep putting out long on and deep mid-wicket. I find it fascinating because it's the area, you know, she's very good at.
Crunched, absolutely crunched through extra cover. Wide-ish mid-off, call it what you like, it was beautifully struck.
It's her area, Dooley, and she'll go there every single time, especially if there's no turn. Look at her, that's on middle stump, and she's created the angle to get through the offside. Fantastic from Danny Wyatt.
She can also be fairly comfortable in the fact that it's not going to turn up the hill. Ball's just going to skid on, damp surface, damp ball. Can open that blade a little bit and slice it away as well. And again, over the top this time. This is good batting. I'm not sure about the option, though, from Australia.
Yeah, it's very hard to bowl to this field with someone who's so offside dominant. And she will take this off middle stump, even leg stump at times. And there she goes again. It's what she does well.
Still no change. Still a long on, deep mid wicket. Tries to tuck her up a little bit more. Gets away with one. Get it on. Three overs gone, 26 without loss.
I think the most difficult thing with what she's trying to bowl there is she has to go hard into the pitch, and then square leg becomes an option for Danny Wyatt. So it's, I think it's probably something they need to look at, the Australians, because off spin against Danny Wyatt is certainly not a great matchup.
Change of ends for Megan Shute. 8 runs in her first over. Her boundary riders will be leg side down the hill. Looking to swing that ball back to the right-handers. Straight to mid on. It's a good start from England's point of view. 27 on the board. Last over of the power play, of course, a 4-over power play. 4 bowlers to bowl 3 overs, 1 bowler to bowl 2. Target 119, bottom of your screen. Finds the gap again. Might not make it all the way. The outfield slowed up. Talia McGrath with the chase. Ball does win.
And again, Wyatt through this offside up the hill. Another great shot from Wyatt. Got the length. Beautifully played.
Hmm. And that crowd that we mentioned before, 21,610, sorry, is a record for an England women's bilateral fixture. And again, carved over the offside. Brilliant. Just carrying on from where she left at the Oval, Danny Wyatt.
Yeah, again, they keep trying to go further and further into leg stump, but Danny Wyatt still gets this one away. That was outside off stump, and that's poor execution.
Yeah, the ball getting damp, and the swing's gone, I think. I'm looking for that angle and that swing, Megan Schutt, but she couldn't find it. This time straight, but mid-off in the way. It's always sliced, though, isn't it? It's always got that little slice. Start it down the left-hand side of the fairway and fade it back into the middle. Clever, very clever from Danny Wyatt this time. Just lay the bat on it, open the blade. Four more.
This is a skillful shot from Danny Wyatt. She's just opened the face. And actually, that went away really quickly to the boundary. Wyatt's on fire, 26 off 14.
Last over of the power play. England off to a flyer.
Yeah!
Short and edge to edge. That's the end of Danny Wyatt. Good response from Megan Schutt. It had been an expensive over, but she's now got the big wicket.
Yeah. That's a big wicket for the Australians. She decided to go with a shorter delivery. Cross seam. Halfway down, and just a thin nick through to Elisa Healy. And the big wicket of Danny Wyatt. What an excellent knock from her. She has to depart for 26, and England are 39 for one.
Well, Nat Siver-Brunt has come out with England in a very good position, a great start. Danny Wyatt has given them that. So just 80 required now from 60 balls with 9 wickets in hand. Most situations, you would say 80 from 60, 9 wickets in hand is very much in the batting side's favour. You know that Australia will fight the whole way, though. Nat Siver-Brunt is out in the middle with Sophia Dunkley now into the power play. Fielding restrictions are done. Got a very fine third, a backward point on the boundary. A fine leg and a deep backward square. Straight up, and underneath it comfortably. And back-to-back wickets for Australia.
They brought Darcy Brown exactly to do that. Ball short at Sophia Dunkley. And that went straight up in the air, straight to Jess Jonathan. They dropped her the other night, but taken tonight just. And Dunkley goes for 9, and England are 39 for 2.
Sophia Dunkley for Jess Johnson and Darcy Brown
for Bob. Wait! Yeah, we all expected maybe a shorter delivery, but I think that was the right move. Bowled the fuller delivery. But yeah, 2 batters on naught. And 80 runs still required.
there is that shorter one.
There's nothing worse, is there, when you know what's going to come, but you don't know when it's coming.
Come Australia, it's coming more often than not now, I tell you. Just didn't look comfortable at all playing that. She didn't look comfortable at the oval.
Yep.
So has to give herself some room. We'll pick up a single, get off the mark.
And I think that's her best way of playing the delivery, as is Dana Wyatt, to actually try and get it through the offside or over Jess Johnson's head, rather than trying to take it on. Because I don't think it's natural. She's six leg side of the ball. So that should be her method to counteract this bouncer policy from the Australians. It's in the men's ashes, it's now in the women's ashes. Here we go.
Yeah, and Dunkley's the same. If I'm Sophia Dunkley, I'm looking to get leg side of it and cut the ball.
Yeah, yeah.
Siva Brunt's underway as well. I mean, neither her nor Capsey look comfortable at all playing the ball from off to leg. And it's been their downfall on a couple of occasions, so I'm with you on that. Terrific comeback over here from Darcy Brown. A wicket and two runs. Last ball. That's full. Should be at least two. And it will be two. So the end of the fifth over. And England are 43 for two.
Numbers are slightly skewed because of the change in overs, change in the format of the game. Now just a 14 over run chase, so Australia a little bit behind there, but lovely shot, super shot. So much will rely on Nat Siva Brunt. Now that's a really good start.
Siva Brunt moving to the offside to create the angle for the sweep shot. Deep in the crease as well. It's beautifully executed. You see the early movement. Jess Johnson tries to go at the stumps.
Same again. That's an opportunity really for Alice Capsey to really make an impact in this series and moving forward. Not easy for the spinner, you can see, trying to dry the ball as much as possible. Oh. 17 runs in the last five innings for Alice Capsey, so not in the best of form, but in this format, and the talent that she has, she can turn that around. Gets away with it somehow. Yes, Johnson, she might have thought that would go for four or six. It's just one. Nat Siva Brunt can't quite believe it. Annabelle Sutherland in the deep. 50 up, but a good lick as well.
Yeah, the intent from Nat Siva Brunt, the minute Jess Johnson's on.
On leg side, all the way. Alice Capsey, maybe, just maybe, finding some best form now.
Alice Capsey, what a clean striker of a cricket ball. She won't mind how many runs she's got in her last few innings. She loves batting at Lord's. It's just a step hit length from Jess Johnson in the arc. Full beautiful swing from Alice Capsey, and it's way over the boundary for six.
Well, not easy bowling spin. And you've seen Jess Johnson, she's got the rag out. It's not easy to get a good grip of the ball. The seam is damp. And 13 runs from the over so far. Ball to go. Sensible. Good stuff. Good sensible cricket. 14 runs from the over, 57 for two. Really tricky situation this for Australia with the ball as it is and the outfield as it is. And Alyssa Healy's just going to have to be as clever, really, as she can be with the conditions. I'm trying to work out which bowlers suit the conditions. It's not going to be straightforward for the spinners, that is for sure.
For me, this is how you get hold of Jess Johnson. She bowls quite flat, quite quick. So if you can hit her from the crease, it's really helpful.
Annabelle Sutherland has been outstanding in the multi-format series so far, Test match and the one dayers or the T20s.
Here's Australia's seamers, wickets. The short balls outside off stump, that seems to be the plan. Wouldn't be surprised if Annabelle Sutherland goes to that here as well.
Gets away with that too, that was short and wide.
I think for me though, to Nat Sivabrunt, you've got to be trying to get her on the front foot. She's someone who's so good on the back foot. Anything back of a length, that's her strong zone.
Yeah, risk and reward. Pitch perhaps suits that, but as you say, Sivabrunt.
Right there.
Can't find that gap at the moment. Well covered leg side. The other night, due in next, Amy Jones, Danny Gibson, Sophie Eccleston, who made such a good contribution in the last game down the order at the Oval. Late call. Annabelle Sutherland not sure.
Yeah, I think Annabelle Sutherland there saw Alice Capsey backing away, and I think in the end it's a fair call.
Yeah, fair enough overhead. Yeah. Lovely looking shot, can't find the gap. Goes to the long one, fine leg up. Yeah. Slower ball, hammered. Absolutely hammered through the offside. Brilliant work, but not quite enough. Megan Shute does so well, but it still rolls onto the boundary edge for four. Crucial boundary to finish the over, 65 for two. Game on a knife edge. England will feel that they're slightly ahead at 65 for two, but they are playing the best side in the world. One of the best players in the world is in the middle for England. Desperate effort, not quite enough. Megan shoot. Yeah, spin out of the attack now. Jess Jonathan finding it hard. One over for 14. Darcy Brown, good two overs so far.
This is the gamble here, isn't it, from Alyssa Healy, the captain. Bring back your strike bowler, wants to break this partnership early. They've been doing a good job at keeping the run rate under that eight and over. Brought back the opener, trying to crack this game open and take the wicket.
Decisions, decisions, skipper. One can bowl two, four can bowl three, so be constantly just making sure you get your bowling options right.
She's lining up the Todd Knighty. Mid-on's in the ring, I can feel it.
Big gap, as Sammy's saying, over mid-wicket. It was offside, excellent. This is really good from Australia. It's really good from Darcy Brown.
We spoke about big moments at the Oval. I think this over here is the big one for England. If you can get through this over without losing that wicket, she's been the strike bowler, she's bowled well tonight.
She's bowled full, hasn't she? My gut feeling is they're waiting for the short ball. And she's bowled full so far. Full again. Can't find the gap. Short ball's covered because third man... Very, very fine. So the ramp shot, she stays offside of the ball. There's that gap that you were talking about, but not quite the middle of the bat. Good work, excellent work, a bit of desperation. Capsey's going to come back for three and does well. Scampered three. Well, that's an excellent over, though. Just five from it in the context of the game. That's very, very good. 70 for two from eight.
Well, that's a great bit of work from Annabelle Sutherland. Down early, the flick back. Knew her mate would be there to tidy it up and get the throw in. Vital, saving one run for her team. This is going to go down to the wire, this game.
Well, animated chat, Lisa Healy. Just had senior players and senior bowlers. Ash Gardner. Somehow, would you believe it, somehow gets a little inside edge and Ash Gardner can't quite believe it. Things running the way of England at the moment.
You see the intent here from Capsey. The minute the spin comes on, she's dancing down the wicket. Yes, she's fortunate, but the bat speed on that.
Oh, it's a big gamble, but I think she feels that, well, she has a lot of faith and trust in Ash Gardner, who's bowled really well so far in the competition in the last few games. She's been the go-to bowler, not easy with the wet ball, and she believes in Ash Gardner.
I think particularly with the lineup they've got, Ash Gardner has been that go-to bowler at the death in the power play throughout the middle to get the wickets. I think particularly having Wareham, the leg spinner, she's going to really struggle to grip the seam if it's wet.
Yeah. Done its way. Alice Capsey's played a really good innings here. She's just 22 from 13, but bearing in mind she'd managed just 17 from a previous five, and the game is on the line. Just giving her side some good impetus here.
Touch it in!
Heaved away leg side. Not quite carrying, they keep running. They will keep running. That Siva Brunt has not the best knee at the moment in terms of an injury, but she will keep running.
That's where the slope just comes into play here. You think you're in the game as a fielder and it just dips on you at the last minute. Just slightly beaten in the flight there, Alice Capsey, but goes through with the shot. George Wareham is out there, makes a great effort, but just doesn't quite get there.
Yeah, all eyes on the fielders as well. Focus on the batting and the bowling. Fielders, the ball is coming your way. Extraordinary shot. More desperation. Big roar, another four. I'm not sure it's quite where she intended, but she'll take it.
I think it's a brilliant shot from Alice Capsey. Backing away, giving herself some room. Ash Gardner sees it, drags the ball down. Capsey knows where the gap is. Manages to get it up and over the bowler. Races away for four.
Big gamble, ball to go, 12 runs from it. Just the one, should just be one to finish the over. It's an expensive one for Australia. 13 from it, 83 for two. Oh, it was just a calculated gamble. Just felt that Ash Gardner, even though spin's not straightforward, she just had a gut feel that Ash Gardner has gone for 13. England now 36 from 30.
Captain and vice captain there on screen. Wouldn't be surprised if vice captain's asking for a bowl right now. Get the Yorkers in. The seamers on.
Just got to go to your best bowler now. The game's just drifting away. You've got to get to break this partnership, go to your most likely. Don't worry too much about what happens at the back end of the innings now. Just break this partnership. Who is your most likely bowler to break this partnership? She's gone with Annabel Sutherland. Understandably, in some ways, she has had a terrific time of it. Capsey on strike. Sensible batting.
She's a brilliant character, Alice Capsey. Loves the big stage, always in the battle. Real competitive on such a young head.
Coach on the right, John Lewis. Three ODIs to follow. Tammy Beaumont surely opening the batting for England in the three ODIs. Maybe, just maybe. Ash's still alive. Bristol next week. Still a way to go here yet. Sliced away. Sliced away. Outfield is slow. Beth Mooney just hauling it back in.
Dug in again from Sutherland, but Nat Siva Brunt sat back in the crease. Didn't get all of it, but it's useful runs nonetheless.
slow ball, dragged by Siva Brand. Call, that is brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant. Ash Gardner, outstanding, saved the boundary.
Read the game there, Nat Siva Brand, knew the short ball would be followed by the slower ball. Thought she'd got it in the gap brilliantly, but that is exceptional work from Ash Gardner.
Pretty good over too, just five runs from it. Up in the air and finds the gap somehow. Things are just running the way of England again at the moment. Fifty partnership.
Batting coach John Lewis there, you never get a smile out of him. Even for a 50 partnership.
Played a lot of cricket with JJ over the years. Clever, very clever. The very best of Alice Capsey. He's not found good form coming into the game. But things are going well for England and Alice Capsey, 93 for two.
Gets it right first ball. I feel it's tailing down leg. Let's have a look at the DRS timer here. Lisa Healy will have a chat with Georgia Wareham. This is maybe just a little bit more pressure. Will we, won't we? I think they knew they weren't.
Yeah, I was with you as well, Mel. I think just as well because of the shot that Nat Siva Brand played, looking to work it down the leg side or on the leg side.
God.
Changes the line, it just falls short. Jonathan, the left-hander at backward point. So pressure on the first two deliveries, 26 from 22. Wareham's done well with their first two balls getting into the over. Yeah. Flatter and quicker, and it's in the air, and it's just going to tease yet another Australian fielder in Mooney. It is now over to Capsey.
Just thinking of their options here, Mel. They can both play the reverse sweep pretty well. Obviously, they'll be playing that with the spin and down the slope, but just because of this pitch, sometimes it can stick in.
Tosses it up, and Siva gets out the way. Wareham can't get a hand on it. Been such a big conversation point over this Ashes summer, men's cricket, women's cricket, making the right decisions in the big moments. Again, tosses it up, it's a low full toss. Yet again, just another single. And this is where Lisa Healy, you can just see her there, just a little handout, just saying stay calm, Australia need to get out of this over. Number of overs have gone for a boundary off the last to release the pressure.
Catch it.
Takes the pace off. It's in the air and it's just short of Harris. Nonetheless, just four singles from that over. 97 for two. It is game on.
Yeah, excellent from Georgia Wareham. As you say, Mel, she's only bowled a couple of overs in the series so far. The first game at Edgbaston, she went for 22. She's just gone for four. Now there's more thinking for the leadership group. Lisa Healy, Talia McGrath, vice-captain, and of course Elise Perry in and amongst there. They've got options. That's the key thing with this Australian side. So many options. Looks like Elise is going to be needing to shoot.
On so many occasions in the big moments, the big matches, Australia, whether it's Meg Lanning or Lisa Healy, have turned back to their most senior bowler. And they're going to do that right here, turning back to Megan Shoot. Got a little bit of tap early. That was Danny White hitting her so superbly well up and over the offside. It is different now. Heavily protected on the leg side. Deep backward square, mid-wicket, long on. And a cover sweeper as well for Capsey. Shoot from the pavilion end. She goes big Oh, she likes that area. The crowd like it. England like it. The pressure valve has been released by Capsey with a six off the first.
And this is the end to go from as well. From the pavilion end, as a right-handed batter, you're hitting down the slope. Yes, they have protection out there. Capsey and Natsiva Brunt will fancy themselves. They will have the confidence to keep going here.
Got to get the length right. And she'll be going for that Yorker length and hasn't got it. And that's back to back. Six from the first, four from the next. And all of a sudden, it's just 12 off 16 needed.
This is such clever batting as well. We've not seen the best of Alice Capsey yet in this T20 series, and she is saving it for when it really counts. A smart option. Straight down the ground. Strikes the ball so powerfully.
She'd hit just 17 runs in her last five innings for England, Alice Capsey. She is 46 from 22. And it's Gardner with the safe hands. Capsey departs four short of the half century. After going 6-4, she's out. Moments in the game. How big is this going to be for Australia, for England, for this record crowd?
Yeah, she's played brilliantly. The youngster, Alice Capsey, 46. Continued the momentum, or actually injected the momentum. Her and Natsiva Brunt, excellent partnership. And on this occasion, she would have fancied clearing the ropes again, but safe hands of Ash Gardner. Well played, Alice Capsey. Really good knock for your side. 46 for her. England, 107 for three.
Partnership of 68 from just 44 deliveries. Boy, did they need that, because they'd lost two wickets on 39. One for 39, two for 39. Then the big partnership between Capsey and Natsiva Brunt gets them up to 107 for three. The equation seems so, so simple. 12 from 15 with seven wickets in hand. But this is up against the world champs, the Commonwealth Games gold medalists. People are still wondering how they won the T20 World Cup final against India. They find a way, Australia. England know that. Now it is the captain out to the middle. Needed bat on ball for that one.
Just have a look at the dismissal of Alice Capsey. She would have fancied clearing the ropes. She didn't get the connection that she got the previous delivery. Ash Gardner, safe hands. Frustration for Alice Capsey. She's done a good job though.
Brilliant job. Wonderful to watch. That's clipped away nicely, and fielding on the boundary line. The elevation of this game, each and every delivery is going sky high. Sutherland saved one. Gardner saved two. Wareham saves two.
It's a feature of their World Cup campaign in the final. They were brilliant. Semi-final as well.
Back of a length, and she picks out Wareham, who comfortably collects that one for the single. Big over there, the wicket of Capsey. 1-1-1 for three. Eight runs, 12 balls. Most importantly here for England, it's Nat Sivabrunt who's going to be on strike. You're more than halfway there, crowd. Not too sure if you can hear the music being belted out over the loud system here. Bon Jovi is blaring here at Lord's, saying we're halfway there. England's a lot closer than a halfway there, I can tell you that. 12 balls to go, 8 needed. Wareham, who just saved runs on the boundary line, has the ball in her hand again. Just 4 runs from her first over. Can she do it again? Pace off the delivery. It'll just be a single to Brown, and it's over to Heather Knight.
Yeah, this is where England just need to keep their head. They're thinking of their boundary option. If it's there, absolutely go for it. Sorry, the coaches say that, but if it's not there, take the easy option.
Aussies, stop. Where are you going? Get back to your seat right now. Unbelievable. Reverse comes out straight to Jess Johnson. For a second, I thought she was going to do the flick up to Grace Harris, but keeping their cool. Why would you leave, Lids? Why?
I feel the crowd are being quite kind to them as well. Just letting them totter out.
That is wonderful. Heather Knight comes out. She's only faced the 2 deliveries. For the confidence to come down the wicket and lift Wareham up and over the infield.
No, she stuck with her strength. She tried the reverse. That is absolutely her strength. It didn't work. Now she's gone to her other strength. Up and over, extra cover. Such good execution under pressure.
They're a shot away, England, from a series win against Australia. There's a reverse. It's pitched well and truly outside leg. Two needed. Balls in hand. What does Elisa Healy do now? She knows it's just one shot. She's still got the 4 out. Deep backward square, mid-wicket, long on, and deep point.
Yes!
Oh, boulder! Smart by Wareham! Flatter, faster. And it's Sivar. Sivabrunt's gone. And is there a little twist in this Ashes tail?
Well, we've had 2 nail biters already.
Yes.
Edgbaston. They managed to chase the total down with 1 ball to spare. And then at the Oval, Australia made a late surge. They fell 3 runs short. And now they've just picked up Nat Sivabrunt at a crucial stage of the game. She goes to 25. 117 for 4.
She's been brilliant, Wareham. Thrown the ball in the crunch time of the game. Didn't bowl in the last game at the Oval. Now has 1 for 10 with 1 delivery to go in her second over. Amy Jones set Edgbaston alight with a 6 off the last ball of the England batting innings as she went 41 off 29. Wants it over with. And it's not a chance because the back foot remained down. Still 2 needed. Still 6 balls to go here at Lord's. 117 for 4.
Amy Jones was going for glory then, wasn't she? Clearing the front leg, trying to go maximum return into the stands. You see it against the spin. Look at that. Clear the front leg. I'm going to do this in one blow. It was a free hit in a way, just because means that Heather Knight is still on strike. Obviously, she's only been in a few balls, but she's got herself going.
A little bit of nerves from the England camp. Two needed, six deliveries, and they'll be from Jess Johnson, and that's no surprise. 27 wickets at just six at an average of nine in the final overs. But this is a different equation now because it is just the two runs needed. So there's a squeeze going on at mid-wicket. Two out on the leg side, backward square and deep mid-wicket as well. Everybody else is up. The offside is an opportunity for Knight.
Yeah!
Big shout for LBW. It's been hit on the foot. Ball and it's been given. Where are those Australians who left the ground? Come back in. We're going upstairs.
We have a player review for LBW. Original decision is out. I've checked front foot, it's a fair delivery. Can I have front on, please? Oh. A ball has passed close to the bat. Can I have ultra edge, please? Okay, roll that through. So clear gap between bat and ball. Just keep rolling through to the pad. Okay, satisfied no bat involved. Can I have ball tracking when ready, please? So pitching in line, impact is umpire's call, wickets, umpire's call. So I'll go back on field to Russell. You can stay with your decision of out. Stand by, on screen, signal now.
The pressure of a chase. The pressure of the home of cricket. The pressure of potentially a series win against the world champions. And there's just been a little bit of a stutter here from England. Knight departs for six. England still need two from five deliveries. And the captain and vice-captain come together, one of the senior heads in Jess Johnson. And it's Danny Gibson coming out. Just her third game for England. Let's have a look at it again, Liz.
Well, it was close, wasn't it? I can understand why it was given on the field. I can also understand why it was reviewed. Yeah, it was close, Heather. It was close. She's done it again though, Jess Johnson. How often does she do it? Such a similar situation to that first game.
Gibson looks for the reverse. It's through. She's got one. She'll come back for two. She doesn't need to. It's the boundary. It's a series win for England at the home of cricket. The first team to have done it since 2017. And they are still in the hunt to regain the Ashes. What a brilliant game.
Well, how about this for a match-winning shot from the young Danny Gibson. She only made her debut recently in this series. Came in as an all-rounder. And she's come in and said, thank you very much. And England are still in this series. They're still in the Ashes. The crowd have been outstanding all evening and they absolutely love that. Excellent execution. Used the crease nicely. And she's done it against one of the best, Jess Johnson, who is so, so effective this stage of the game.
Fear? What's fear? I'm just going to reverse sweep one of the best T20 bowlers in the world for a win for England.